Okay, you gentlemen, went through the rules in the locker room. I want a good, clean fight. Protect yourself at all times. You must obey my commands. Punches right here. Golpes aquí. Bueno. Debajo, no. So punches at the top are okay. Below that, no. On you, right here is okay. Debajo, no. Preguntas?
No.
Questions? Good luck. God bless. Buena suerte. Touch him up. Right? Sir? Ma'am? Good?
Lamont Peterson is wearing the silver and purple trunks. Felix Diaz Jr. is wearing the red, white, and the blue.
Puppies.
12 rounds. Welterweight division, here we go. Dave Ferris, Steve Cunningham with you here in Fairfax, Virginia tonight.
Didn't know Diaz was a southpaw. Sometimes that poses a problem for fighters, orthodox fighters, but Peterson is a very well-tested champion.
Anytime you have orthodox versus a southpaw, we talk about the battle of foot position, but expand a little bit why that's so important with that lead foot when these fighters are squaring off and they're in close proximity to each other.
Because if the southpaw's foot is not on the outside or yours on the outside and you come in for the attack, that foot is on the inside in between the attacker's legs, and which can make you off balance. You know, it's mainly a balance thing. So any punch you throw, he has to reset his feet, which is dangerous because that takes time. Too much time in the pocket means you can get hit.
Diaz ripping some nice body shots there on Peterson.
In actuality, that's the main attack for Diaz. You know, I see body work, bring upstairs big shots. And we see this isn't going to be a boxing Peterson right here. This is going to be a bang Peterson. I mean, and you also got to know he's at home. He wants to liven up the crowd here at home, give him something special to go home and talk about. So he's trying to go for a knockout. Peterson is cut, I believe. Seems. Good shot, Diaz.
Good shot, nice Diaz. Looping hand there from Peterson. Another right hand connects. Diaz fires right back.
We have a gold medalist here, you know? It's
absolutely
nothing to play with, nothing to underestimate, size-wise or anything. Good straight left from Diaz. A little reset in here. Now we're back to let's fill each other out. Good shot by Peterson. Wow.
Wow.
10 seconds. 10 seconds.
Peterson trying to put on a little show. Be invigorating, be exciting. You got to get this win, though.
Round number one in the books. Both of them traded back and forth a significant amount in that round. How do you see it?
I had to lean towards Diaz for that round. You know, he landed very good, clean, telling shots, more so than Peterson did in my eyes.
Peterson there with a nice uppercut. Didn't land that cleanly, though. More of a graze off the forehead of Diaz. Diaz was
sure
pressing forward
right
through much of that
like
fight. Let's hear what his
corner has
to say.
Look underneath, but hold the phone. Do not abandon the jab, all right? That's key. Trying to come over the top, that's his thing, but he's leaning into the ups, okay? Uh-huh. Sharper now.
Okay. Rip my shots?
Yeah.
You got a shell up in there?
Yeah, just a little bit, but hold up phone, all right?
I'll hold the phone.
Down the jab. Everything under you good. Yeah,
that's
rip.
Man. That's all he got.
That's it.
Okay.
I thought Peterson sustained a cut there. It's just a crease in his cheek and his nose, pretty deep. My mistake.
Round number two is underway. Peterson, silver and purple. Diaz, red, white, and blue. This one's scheduled for 12 rounds. The unofficial scorecard of Steve Cunningham gave that first round to Felix Diaz.
Peterson in more of a boxing position now, more so than the I'm gonna stand in front of you and let's bang. Diaz showed him something in the first round. You know, he showed him, I'm not here to lay down. I can do this too. And I'm crafty. Just as that right hook he just landed.
Seems like every time that Peterson loads up and lands a big shot, Diaz fires right back with a counter.
Because you have in Diaz a smaller fighter. You know, his shots get to you faster. You know, he should be faster. He's a little sharper. Lamont Peterson, his shots aren't that fast. And Lamont throws him shots thinking he's going to get a KO, and he looks at his shots sometimes.
Work out of it. Let him go, Lamont.
Nice trickery there by Diaz, clean, you know, to get some more space and work and spin him out. Diaz is showing a lot of ring generalship, you know, intelligence, things that you learn in amateurs also.
Diaz firing off again. Lamont Peterson walking him down, but nice counter punching there from Diaz.
But if you see Diaz backed up to the ropes, you know, it's like he wants to be there. He's feeling very comfortable. It's like he's trying to lure Lamont to the fight he wants.
Peterson ripping some body shots there that connect and go unanswered. Nice punch on the exchange, as well as the break by Peterson.
If Peterson continues a body attack like that and the press, I believe you may see Diaz breaking down a bit in a few rounds.
Peterson doing some nice work inside right now. Peterson's got Diaz backed up into the corner.
Diaz doesn't want to be there this time.
No, he does not. And Peterson's making him pay for it. Final 10 seconds of round number two. And Peterson once again has Diaz pinned up in the corner as round number two comes to a close. Great round for Lamont Peterson.
Yes, sir. Yeah, no doubt. That's a Peterson round all the way.
And you see his brother there who fought earlier tonight. That fight lasted all of about 3 seconds. He got the victory. His opponent just quit on him.
Don't give him nothing cheap. All right, hunt him down.
Here we go. Lamont Peterson doing work on the inside. Diaz still game, firing back certainly, but Lamont Peterson just doing great work up close. In round number one, we thought that Diaz got the better of those exchanges, but nice adjustment there from Lamont Peterson. At the beginning of that round number two, he was keeping his distance, like you said, much more of a boxing stance, and then he just closed the distance and went to work.
Yeah, he's making it a variation of attacks, which is very smart. You know, I know his trainer. I know his trainer is very smart, and I'm sure he's telling him to do that. You know, mix it up inside, outside. Keep this guy guessing. What's he going to do? What does he want to do?
Again, our unofficial scorecard, one round apiece. Here we go. Round number three is underway. Lamont Peterson, silver and purple. Felix Diaz, red, white, and blue. Dave Ferris, Steve Cunningham with you. Beautiful Saturday afternoon just outside the nation's capital, and these two putting on a show tonight. Rolling off another great co-feature. Looks like we have another fun fight on our hands here.
Lamont Peterson has found the home for that uppercut numerous times in first round, second round, and he's done it in this round also.
Seeing some showmanship once again there from Lamont Peterson. That got him into a little bit of trouble in round number one, but it looks like after that round number two, he's got that confidence back, Steve.
Yes, sir. Yes, I see it.
Diaz finds himself backed up into a corner. That time he spins right out of it, though.
Diaz is trying to be crafty. He's trying to make space for himself. because Lamont Peterson now is smothering him. He's in his chest, which is the world where Diaz should want to work, but Lamont does it so good. He must have took a page out of the Williams book there. Shots from all type of angles, anywhere, anything works.
And Peterson is doing exactly what Williams did in that last fight, where he's just stalking his opponent, walking him down.
Yeah.
Diaz, though, he's still game. He's right in the pocket, firing back. Just curious who's going to land that big shot first. Really earns that respect of the other fighter.
Diaz, being a short guy, he's naturally comfortable in that close. That's where he wants to be. But as I said, Lamont Peterson works so good on the inside, you know, with those body shots, that's where we fight. We got this phone booth thing going here.
Make it heavy now.
Shot there from Diaz.
Lamont just continually putting on the pressure, stalking, standing in front of him, making him punch, making him exert himself while Lamont's defense catches the punches, most of
them. Lamont once again has Diaz up against the ropes.
Right hook from Lamont Peterson. Peterson must have felt he did. He landed some really good shots. Didn't want to give away anything at the end of the round.
How do you score that one? That was tough, huh?
Yeah, it was a tough one, but I'll give that to Peterson because his punches landed earlier in the round were more telling, you know, more so than Diaz. And you can see he also, you score a fight more on punches and controlling the ring. Peterson controlled the ring. He put the pressure on and landed punches.
And Peterson's corner had a pretty short talk with him, whereas Diaz, still on his bench, getting instruction. Peterson basically just said, yep, don't need the bench. I'm good to go.
And there's an intimidation factor in that also. That's the old George Foreman
style. Not tired, not scared, yeah.
Yeah.
Keep it standing.
Let me see that square fit. Hey, yeah. Este round, ya lo dominaste, Nico. Hay que seguir igual.
Here we go, round number four, 12 potential. Mont Peterson,
keep him up.
Purple and silver. Felix Diaz, red, white, and blue. Diaz, the Olympic gold medalist. Lamont Peterson, hometown favorite, 14 years as a pro. Certainly has seen it all. Can the Olympic gold medalist come along, though, and show him something new?
Sneaky shots by Diaz. There's two of them right there so far this round.
Yeah, they snuck through, too.
Three. Seems Diaz is more in a boxing mindset, you know. Good shots, both guys.
Yeah, they're both just ripping away at that body. Nice short hook there from Peterson.
I don't think Diaz wants to stay there like that when Peterson is cooking. That's the good kitchen. That's the kitchen Peterson was made in.
Behind the jab. He's gonna show you what's coming the whole time.
Oh, cabeza, no. Cabeza, cabeza.
Underneath.
Good slip by Peterson. I mean, he's in there, he's in close, and he's seeing what's coming. He's reacting well, his defense is high, and he's scoring shots.
Hang him down and finish him.
Short left hook. And these type of things are gonna look good in the judge's eyes, even if this goes to the scorecard. With Peterson walking down, just even throwing little shots, touching them.
Diaz with a couple of nice unanswered shots, though. D Diaz seems like he's having more success when he stays very mobile. He doesn't let Peterson walk him down. When he's the one that's controlling where this fight is moving, he's having a lot more success. But when Lamont Peterson just starts to walk him down and puts him in that corner, that's when Peterson's really able to open up. Here he is again. And Diaz does a nice job of circling out.
Yeah, it seems like we've turned another tide here. You know, in the beginning of the round, it was all Peterson. Now Diaz is being very smart, elusive, and he's finding a home for his punches. Peterson is just touching him with that jab, touching him, trying to get him to stand still so he can go to work on the inside.
Diaz had a nice counter shot there. Peterson left that jab hanging out there a little bit too long. And Diaz fired off a nice right hand. Peterson swinging hard, so is Diaz. Final seconds here. Fourth round is in the books. Boy, looking at some of the action here. Straight left hand there, right down the pipe from Diaz. That one connects. And you see Diaz, as opposed to firing another shot right after that, waiting to see how Peterson was going to react to it.
Yeah, that was a good round for Diaz in my book.
Score that one for Diaz?
Yeah, I mean, in the end, he also put on a nice display of movement and control in the ring. Like I said, depends on what type of judges you have. They like to see a guy putting in work at the end of the round, it seems. Diaz may have won that round in the judges' scorecard.
So again, unofficial, but we're all tied up at two apiece. This is a very close fight. Premier Boxing Champions always doing a great job, in my opinion, with the matchmaking, and this is another fight that was very well put together. Through four rounds, it's been incredibly close, and there you go again with Peterson refusing to sit down.
I got it.
Standing up in his corner in between rounds. We head to round number five.
You know, sometimes getting up out of the corner takes energy also. I know some fighters who do this also, just stand up in between rounds, preserve energy, you know.
Just because they don't want to have to sit down and then stand back up?
Yeah, it's like squats, you know. Anything to help you, man.
Even one squat is too much when you're putting all of it on the line out there in these rounds.
Good choice, good combination by Peterson, that 1-2. It's a money maker for fighting a southpaw.
And keep in mind, Peterson does have a 2-inch reach advantage, so keeping it at distance also does work for him. Once again, Diaz backed up into the corner. And he pushes out.
It's been all Peterson so far for this round.
Crowd's getting restless. Diaz pushing forward.
Good move.
Yeah.
Back to work. Good move on Peterson's part. Stay elusive, stay away from his punches, and land a clean shot.
Point of round number five, Diaz the more active fighter. Peterson looks a little bit out of sorts right now. It's waiting for his opportunity.
Diaz gets he's very slick, very elusive. And in him doing that, it makes Peterson have to come to him into Diaz's world, and Diaz can just launch punches and counter and move when he wants. Diaz putting in work, but he's not landing clean, but he's still putting in work, and that looks good to judges.
Man, he's ripping those shots, too. Some of those are landing to the body, but you're right. All of the shots upstairs, Peterson doing a nice job of keeping his hands up, checking most of those punches.
Yeah.
Boy, Diaz is throwing a lot of punches.
Good legs on Diaz. You know, he's utilizing, when he utilizes his legs and keeps the ring, controls the ring, he's looking good, man. He's looking very good. Oh. Peterson's Diaz finding a home with that seconds, jab, but I know personally, jab to these judges means nothing.
Another good round in the books for Felix Diaz. Assuming you see it the same way, that actually puts him ahead.
Yeah, I give that round to Diaz also. Peterson started out pretty well in the beginning, but Peterson took over halfway mark to the end. He controlled everything.
I don't want too much weight. Feel me? Never want to leave it in the judge's hand. You get there, but I need to pull a trick. He's trying to box and walk to a left hand, man. Feel me? Got to cut the ring off. Stop falling.
Good advice.
All right, show me. Let's go.
Good advice from the corner.
There you see Diaz ripping some of those body shots. Round number six, we are set to go, and Diaz is waiting at the center of the ring. Dave Ferris, Steve Cunningham with you here in Fairfax, Virginia. And Steve, I love it when a corner is honest with their fighter. Instead of just telling them that it's all pie in the sky, they're doing great out there. Honestly saying, look, you may be losing this fight in the judges' scorecards. You gotta get out there and work, which is basically what Peterson's corner told him. I can appreciate that.
No, that I totally, that's the way I want it in my corner. Give me the real, you know, I can deal with that. Diaz in here being really crafty, really tricky, making shots available for himself, utilizing Peterson's aggression to his advantage.
But already here in round number six, we see Peterson turning it up a little bit, starting to stalk once again, which is where he found success in some of the earlier rounds.
Peterson's gonna have to, he's gonna have to do more than just touch him with the jab. He stalks him good, and then he gets him there. He needs to go to work, just like that. But, and we have Lucid Diaz, gets away.
Keep that jab going.
I would totally like to see Peterson bang away at the body a little bit more, but I mean, Diaz is so elusive, you're gonna pay getting close to the body.
It's a great observation. Every time that Peterson has ripped one to the body, he always eats one or two in retaliation from Diaz.
Break, step back, step back, step back. Marks.
Good straight left to the body from Diaz. That's the second one he's landed this round. Diaz is looking very comfortable and very confident right now. Good straight right by Peterson and an uppercut. Peterson's doing a good job with that measuring stick, that jab there. He's just got to put a little more together in my eyes. Versus Diaz's volume and output. Good
nice
sneaky
short
left.
Hook there, yeah.
Oh, no. Left.
Diaz's height is his advantage in this fight.
Yeah, he is working hard too. He gets down low and he just starts to load up on Peterson in some of those circumstances. Able to sneak some shots in.
Good counter left hook by Diaz. No matter what Peterson does, Diaz smothers him with more shots after. There's no way you can not give him a round for that.
That's the end of six. Do you give that one to Diaz as well?
Yes, I
do.
How
are
we doing, sir?
Looking at him in the corner there, Diaz still looking fresh.
Big up, my dear, you're welcome.
Here's some of the action from that sixth round.
Don't give him what he wants.
That's exactly what you said there, Steve. Okay. Diaz just ripping away to the body. And
stay on the jab.
Lamont Peterson is trying to find him and trying to punish him, but he's just so elusive, it's hard to do.
Okay. Okay? Combinaciones de tres y cuatro golpes. Y después de combinaciones, vamos a quedar muy bajito. Y ángulos, ángulos. Él viene bien recto para enfrente. Trabaja, trabaja, trabaja y muévete. Trabaja y muévete y no te encuentras. Vámonos.
Peterson with a big right and a big left that missed. We talked about how elusive Diaz was. That was part of his problem there in that sixth round. We're back live now here in round number seven. Second half of this fight.
Sometimes when a fighter's going for the knockout, he's going for the kill, that plays into the hand of the other fighter, because that's what he's expecting you to do, and they've trained for this. Diaz looks very comfortable in this position, being the smaller man and possibly the not so powerful guy, but he's putting in punch volume.
Oh, big left hand there from Diaz. That one stopped Peterson in his tracks.
A guy like Diaz is difficult to fight. He's short, he's a southpaw, he's elusive, and he knows what he's doing. This is not an easy fight for Peterson at all.
Seems like every time that Peterson tries to throw a hook at the head of Diaz, Diaz will check it and then throw a right over top of that hook. It's very nice timing on the part of Diaz.
Very, very nice timing. You know, I train my sons and my nephew, and I tell them, once you put that punch out, you got to bring it back just as fast, because that counterpunch is coming.
Diaz doing a masterful job right now of counterpunching. And while you hear the crowd supporting Peterson in the midst of this battle, that's something that Diaz pointed out coming into this fight. He said, look, I don't care that he's got a home field advantage. It just doesn't matter to me. I fought at a high level before, fighting in the Olympics, very pressurized situation. And I have to agree that Diaz is doing a nice job of just pressing forward and trying to fight his fight.
He's making Peterson do what he wants. He's making Peterson come to him. He's making Peterson miss. He's making Peterson cover up. And he's making Peterson take punches. He slowed down his volume now. Maybe he's gotten a little winded, but we'll see if he turns it up before the end of the round. Peterson is touching him a bit more this middle part of the round. It's a funny thing with these two guys. One guy starts off good, then the other guy comes on. You know, it's just back and forth. It's hard to score these rounds.
Work out of it.
And while Diaz is complaining to the ref, Peterson sneaks a couple of shots in.
Diaz is having a ball in there. He's very comfortable and relaxed.
10 seconds.
That's just about, as I said, once you fight on that Olympic level, the gold medal, bronze medal, silver medal, you're already a pro. You should already be fighting for a world title.
All right, how do you score it?
I had to get that round to Diaz again. I mean, Peterson came on, but Diaz punch volume and output in the beginning, and his punches landed was more.
So again, unofficial scorecard here, but Diaz up 5-2 over the hometown favorite, Lamont Peterson. Big right hand there, just misses from Diaz. The real story, though, is that he was continually throwing those punches.
Yes.
And he has been this whole fight. Loading up, trying to land not just the home run shots, but also just nice counters.
Yeah,
Peterson, though, he's firing right back. He's game. But you see, every time that Peterson fires a shot and lands, it seems like Diaz answers with two or three. Right there, and then coming right back. Oh, that one just missed.
Yeah. That's the game plan of Diaz, you know. You see, he's got Juan Guzman in his corner. You know, Juan Guzman is a very, very good fighter. You know, and he fights similar to Diaz. So you can expect similar things.
Round 8 of 12 is here. Lamont Peterson, silver and purple. Felix Diaz Jr., red, white, and blue. Scheduled for 12 in this welterweight bout.
They're banging right now, they're rumbling. Peterson back in stalk mode. You don't see no jab, and he's just walking forward.
I'll be curious to see if he's able to keep this up for the entire round. It seems like this corner implores him in between every round to start stalking again, to make the fight yours. Stop going into Felix Diaz's territory and letting him set the pace. Peterson was having success when he was the one pressing the action. But it seems like at the beginning of every round, Peterson starts doing that and then ends up backing off that stance. Curious to see as this round wears on where we end up.
Keep him up, Lamont, keep up. Little low, little low.
It's like now he's in Diaz's chest so much, Diaz doesn't have room to be that elusive and score shots.
Work out of it, work out. Work out of it.
And Diaz's output is down very low from the last round.
Keep him up.
I still haven't seen the vicious body attack from Peterson that, you know, I would have liked to see from him.
A little
bit too much headhunting, but, you know, like I said, we're not in there. He's still going to work, though. It's too much time to walk in front of a guy and just stand there. He's got to throw punches. Peterson's got to throw punches.
Yeah, he's doing a nice job of getting Diaz into the ring, or into the corner of the ring, rather, but then Diaz just circling right out. And like you said, Steve, Lamont Peterson threw exactly zero punches in either of those instances. He walked him into two different corners and didn't throw a single punch.
Well, then, like I said before, you had that issue where you're trying to knock a guy out. You know, you feel you're more superior than this guy. I want to knock him out. You get tunnel vision on certain punches. He's not giving me the right hand, so I'm not going to throw it. There's that body shot. Come on, there it is again. Yes, that's what he needs. And you see Diaz is going into a frantic mode now. You know, he dips and he's hugging. That pressure with those body shots takes those legs away from Diaz, and he's not going to be as elusive.
That is the end of the eighth round. And Lamont Peterson, although the output wasn't quite as high in that one, he did do the stalking, and it looked like Diaz slowed down. You giving that one to Peterson?
No doubt, no doubt. There's no doubt, and it should be no doubt in anyone's mind, judges or fans, that Peterson took that round. Stalk landed the better shots, cleaner shots. Diaz looked like he was running to an extent, you know, just trying to stay clear, but Peterson did a great job staying in his chest.
Still a very close fight. Both of these fighters, about half of the time, are knocking their opponents out. Neither of these fighters has appeared rocked in this fight, so I would be surprised if we see a knockout. So the judges, how they're viewing this fight really matters. You see Diaz firing back there. Did a nice job on that counter. But Lamont Peterson just pressing forward. And Steve, you were talking about those body shots. A nice rip there.
Those body shots will steal the legs away from an elusive Diaz. You know, I think we're going into the eighth round now, or ninth.
Ninth round, yeah.
And, I mean, it's never too late. You still got to put that work in, into that body.
9 of 12. Welterweight bout here in Fairfax, Virginia. Dave Ferris, Steve Cunningham. Great to be with you today at the Eagle Bank Arena, George Mason University. Latter part of this fight, Lamont Peterson getting aggressive. Diaz firing back.
See, in that exchange, the shorter guy should have won the exchange, but I give that exchange win to Lamont Peterson. Like I said, that's the kitchen he brews in, you know, in close, body work.
And you talked about that measuring stick and that jab. Lamont Peterson's been firing it out. Threw a nice left hook there just a moment ago. Certainly stung Diaz a little bit.
Cabeza. Mira la cabeza.
Ooh, nice exchange. Diaz landing a big shot.
Diaz is a little more active this round, but also with Peterson. This is a close one right here. They're going at it. That's that body work. You put that body shot in and brought that right hand right back up to the head. Good combination, Peterson.
Mono sleeping, hands are free. Work out of it. No punch, no punch. No. Clean. Bucks.
Oh, big clash there in the center of the ring. Now Diaz has Lamont Peterson up in the corner. He's peppering him.
Quick, no punch.
Now the tides have turned. You know, it's Diaz putting on the pressure and throwing punches, but Peterson isn't going anywhere.
Cabeza.
This is going to be a fight of wills, as it has been. Fight of wills. Who's going to make the other fighter fight the way I want you to fight? Good overhand right. Didn't land that clean, but it landed. And Diaz fired right back.
And the crowd here in Fairfax, Virginia, certainly appreciating the action. Lamont Peterson pressing forward. Diaz in the corner once again, firing shot after shot.
10 seconds, Diaz Segundos.
Diaz wants to get out of that corner, and Peterson pushes him right back in it and said, no, you're going to take this. Take it.
Wow, what a great round. 9 in the books. The crowd is appreciating it here just outside of the hometown of Lamont Peterson. He has really brought boxing back in the Washington, D.C. area in a big way. And let's listen to what his corner has to say.
Keep pressing him behind the jab. The wheel's coming off. Right hand can be used. His only weapon he's looking for is the counter left hand over the top. Hold the phone. Don't get yourself too close where you smother your body punches. You got me? Half step back and give me some angles when you get inside.
Excellent advice there. Do you give that last round to Lamont Peterson?
No doubt, man. He did what he's supposed to do, especially at home. He got the crowd standing up, cheering for him at the end.
Big uppercut there, and Lamont Peterson throws a left following that one that grazes off the head of Diaz. And Diaz, even backed up into the corner, was still firing back. But the real story of that round for me is that Lamont Peterson was relentless in walking down Diaz. Again, it's unofficial, but we've got ourselves a very close fight. We are in the 10th round now. Felix Diaz up 5-4 on our unofficial scorecards.
Work out of it.
Listen, a fighter like Lamont Peterson, man, he's been in this position before with top guys, Danny Garcia, you know, Amir Khan, all these other top guys. He knows how to cook. He knows he needs to turn it up in these last few rounds. I'm looking forward to seeing him turn this up, just like he did last round.
Yeah, his last fight against Danny Garcia that happened at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn, New York, did not go in his favor. It was a split decision for Danny Garcia, albeit a majority decision for him nonetheless. I'm sure that Lamont Peterson does not want that to happen to him again, losing another razor-close decision.
Yeah, that was one of them situations where it depended on, you know, to an extent, what type of judge that was judging the fight, you know. Peterson utilized the ring, he utilized ring generalship, but he wasn't really scoring a lot of telling blows. But then in the end, oh my goodness, he came on heavy. So I'm looking to see him do that again tonight.
Yeah, we've seen time and time again from Lamont Peterson that he has definitely got 12 plus rounds in him. He can keep his foot on the gas and going. Diaz is still looking very fresh himself here in the 10th round.
Yeah, Diaz right now is just getting space right now with these spins and turns. We haven't seen that punch volume as we've seen in the past couple rounds yet. But, I mean, it is the 10th round. These are the championship rounds. Seemed to be uncomfortable a bit there for Diaz, the smothering of Peterson. Good left hand by Diaz. And that's what his corner, that's what Peterson's corner just told Peterson. That's what Diaz is looking for. He's looking for that counter left hand. And sure enough, he landed it.
Diaz once again backed into a corner, spins out of that one. Lamont Peterson remains aggressive.
It's a good body shot. Heavy, strong body shot to the body of Diaz.
No punch, I got you.
He's still in that same corner.
Segundos, 10 seconds. 10 segundos.
Final seconds here of round number 10. Will someone make a statement?
Tempo.
Nope, bell sounds. It's a tough one.
Yeah, but I'd give that round to Peterson. Okay. You know, he stalked more. You know, he's trying to land a blow. And Diaz looked like he was running at some instances, you know. So I'm sure that's not going to pan over right with the judges. That round's going to go to Peterson.
Too much trying to load the punch.
So, again, it's unofficial, but we have got it tied up 5 rounds apiece going into the 11th round. This is a tight fight. Do you believe that Lamont Peterson is going to continue, have the gas tank to continue, like we've seen in the past in this particular fight, dealing with a very tough to pin down Felix Diaz?
I think we're going to see more of an animal come out of Peterson in these last few rounds. I'm sure his corner's telling him, listen, we don't want, like they told him before, we don't want to keep this in the judge's hands. We don't want another Danny Garcia situation. So they're trying to tell him, go for the knock, I'll put the pain on him. But we're going to see more of an animal come out of Peterson.
Yes, snuck one through there. But again, notice all of these highlights. Even if it is Diaz landing the shot, it's Peterson that has him pushed up into the corner. Here we go, 11th round. Lamont Peterson, silver and purple. Felix Diaz Jr., red, white, and blue. 11 of 12 scheduled in the welterweight division. And once again, Peterson has Diaz pinned up in the corner.
Back to the jab.
Nice right hand. Partially checked.
Keep the jab on him, Carl. The jab will open it up.
Peterson's corner calling for the pressure.
Pick it up, son. Let's go.
He needs to, I believe he needs to put pressure on. I think he needs to look like he's getting this guy, like he's attacking him, like he's bringing noise. I believe he needs that. You can't let a guy like Diaz craft you out of a decision, you know, be too crafty and slick, and he's not really hurting you, he's not really doing anything, but he's putting punch volume on you and making you miss. That looks bad.
Work out of it.
Man, get rough with him, man.
Mm-hmm.
Work out of it. Break, no punch. No punch.
Peterson's corner saying get rough with him. Seems like Peterson's taking a little break, you know, from what his corner's been telling him to do. We got a minute and 14 seconds left. Let's see if Peterson turns it up, because this is going to go to Diaz as far as it is now.
Yeah, Diaz is really pressuring. Actually had, you know, as you saw, Peterson leaned over the ropes there for a solid 20, 25 seconds.
Whoa. Stop,
and again,
stop,
he's pressing
stop.
On.
Come on, okay? No mas.
And the output of Peterson really has slowed.
Yeah, this round's probably one of his lowest numbers, lowest rounds throughout the fight. Peterson chose to box on the outside with Diaz this round versus good left hook by Peterson. Versus go for the pressure and kill as his corner was calling
go,
for.
Lamont. Let him go. Let him go. Let him go.
At this stage in the fight, 11th round, unless you're a Mike Tyson powerful Kovalev powerhouse type fighter, a big left hook like that really doesn't didn't shake
you.
Diaz, you know,
because
we got guys that are winded, and now he's used to his punches now, you know.
So round 11 is in the books. We're going to go to our 12th and final round, and that one actually puts Felix Diaz up one round.
I believe so. I believe that was a Diaz round, no doubt.
And again, you know, who knows what the judges are seeing tonight, but this is an incredibly close fight. Let me ask you this, Steve. Are you surprised that it is as close as it is, or did you expect this?
I am a little surprised at it. I mean, you shouldn't be when you're talking about a gold medalist, but we've also seen at times in Peterson's career where he doesn't pull the trigger as often as he should or as long as he should. But with Diaz being crafty, it's made it a little more difficult.
And this right here definitely made a statement where Diaz had Peterson just pushed over the ropes there for 20, 25 seconds. And you see his brother imploring him to just do something in that round, and it never happened. So here we go. 12th and final round. Eagle Bank Arena, George Mason University, Fairfax, Virginia. Dave Ferris, Steve Cunningham.
All right, let's do it.
Here we go. 3 minutes ticking off the clock already. And Diaz goes right back to work.
Seems Peterson is just going to go with the boxing part of, you know, in the fight instead of trying to bang Diaz, you know, bang him out, you know, to the body and bring that hook up to the head. Good shot there. Good body shot by Peterson.
Oh, hold him, Lamont.
Wow.
Swung so hard it spun him around.
Get out of there.
Peterson, I mean, as you can see, he's loading up on these shots. He's trying to be impressive. You know, when you have a guy like Diaz who's not worrying about the big shot as much, he's trying to put volume.
Volume, and he's moving so much, and you always wonder how the judges are seeing that.
He's like a four-year-old.
Yeah, he really is. And he's got Peterson up against the ropes, lands a nice uppercut there, another one.
Let him go, Lamont. Let him go.
Yeah, Diaz is doing his job, man. I mean, he's doing a good job here, trying to convince everybody, I want to win.
Cabeza, watch your head. Cuida la cabeza. Break, no punch.
Referee speaking a little Espanol for the people.
Is that one of the prerequisites nowadays? You got to be bilingual to be a referee?
I think so.
Buck 20 left in this fight. Lamont Peterson's got to do something here. Diaz has been hard at work in these last two rounds. Normally the home stretch is pretty good for Lamont Peterson. Felix Diaz, though, outworking him right now.
It's like Peterson just walks him down and then stands in front of him. He's waiting for a specific shot to be open to launch, and he just needs to launch punches. And I mean, that's exactly what Diaz is doing. He's punching. So far, I can't get his round of Peterson at all. Share will to win, boxing generalship. Wow, what is going on here? And out punch by output is Diaz.
And the Olympic gold medalist back to work here in the final 30 seconds of this fight.
Break! No. Quit holding him, Lamont. Quit holding him, okay?
And I don't know if Lamont thinks he's up on the judges' scorecards or if he's just resigned to the fact of what's happened so far, but still not a lot of output here in the final seconds.
It's like Lamont feels he has this power that's just going to stop Diaz, you know, with one punch. I mean, he's just throwing one big shot.
And Diaz still hustling here. Final seconds of this fight. That is the end. And Lamont Peterson heads back to his corner. Felix Diaz follows him over. Show his respects.
Thank you, Brian.
And Lamont's got a look on his face.
Thank you, ma'am.
I don't know if he's complaining about something or if he thinks that he won.
Something wrong with his rib or something. I don't know.
Felix, great fight. Good fight,
good
son.
Good job, Rob.
Thank you very
awesome
much.
Awesome job.
Thank you very much.
Good job.
Joel, good job. Hold on. Good job. Thank
you. So the last one there, you score for Diaz as well.
Yes. I mean, it's just too much, you know, too much punch volume, too much energy, too much action from Diaz.
So that would be seven rounds for Felix Diaz, five for Lamont Peterson. We'll see if the judges agree here in just a moment. But yeah, I mean, Peterson, you see him, he's talking to the ref now. He's still complaining, it looks like about, I would assume it's got to be his rib. Doesn't look to be in a lot of pain, but can we hear him?
What the? Yeah.
So
Something on the side of his torso.
Good fight, Joel. Very good fight.
Cramps? Is that what they said?
They had the will itself through. We in the fight. What you gonna do? You know what I mean?
Yes, I did.
Good job, baby.
Sandy possibly had cramps.
Gonna be a champ.
And look, what is Peterson doing right now?
Thank you, Steve. Thank you, Steve.
Pushing out those cramps, I guess.
I guess. It's like he's at a Pilates class.
He's done, huh?
Cramping from the sixth round.
Yeah, that's all that. Yeah, yeah.
You couldn't really walk, of course, but you know, you're in a fight. What you gonna
do? What you gonna do? You gotta bang it out.
Yeah.
Man. You did good, though. Did good, brother.
Thanks.
He's a tough little fucker, man.
Yeah.
He's slick. He's slick. Did he sting you one time? Did he sting you one time?
Yeah.
It appeared like maybe he was stung. I don't know if he would just take a little break, you know?
Yeah.
And so you see Lamont Peterson, he's got the ice pack there on his side.
I knew. I was like, they probably think I'm hurt. I know he thought I was hurt.
He did, yeah.
He tried to rush me.
Right.
But I was good.
Okay. I didn't see it in your eyes. I just saw it in your movement. That's why
I was yeah. Off balance, way off balance.
But you look good, man. But he's so short, and he's southpaw. You know. Oh, yeah.
Southpaw and he's short. I like
gold medalist, man, you know.
I like fighting tall fights.
Yeah, because it's just different. It's totally different, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it says it's easier to fight taller fighters. I feel it. It's a little more to hit on a taller guy. And they're right in front of you sometimes.
The contest, 114-114, a draw. Overruled by judges Dorothea Perry, who has the contest, 117-111. And Judge Mark D'Attilio, who has the bout, 116-112, for your winner by majority decision, Lamont Kingpin Peterson.
And there you have it. Big pop from the crowd in his hometown, and then a smattering of boos to follow. Can't say that I disagree with the crowd that is upset here. Felix Diaz came in. Did a great job tonight, but the hometown kid gets the nod, Lamont Peterson.